Welcome to the Cult Classic Horror Show. Every week, you can have the conversations you've always wanted to have about the films you love.
Shut up!
Get rid of your distractions and prepare yourself.
You got a big surprise coming to you. You're not going anywhere.
Welcome everybody to the Cult Classic Horror Show. Danny Bonin here.
Welcome guys, Scotty Bonin here.
We are
The Blood Brothers.
Along with the
Rob O'Neill. What's happening?
I said the. I should have just said along with.
That's the same difference.
But you came in and you said it. That's awesome.
I came in. I was on fire tonight, man.
Dude, you freaking rock.
I got a belly full of barbecue and mashed potatoes right now. I'm ready to go, son.
You came in like a wrecking ball.
Dude, you... We usually have to announce your name for you. You came in freaking like on fire.
Yeah, I usually say, and the Rob O'Neill, because for some reason, usually you sit there like an idiot when I say, and like you don't have any idea.
Look,
what
okay,
the hell's
I
going
stall,
on.
Man. It's not, look, I'm not good at introductions, okay?
But I like it when we announce you and you're like, hey.
Hi, guys.
I'm Mr. Hanky the Christmas Poo.
No, I do like it how you just announced your name now. That was nice. That was slick.
Seed
I'm stepping
of,
up, man.
Seed
I'm part
of
Chucky. We're a trio now.
Yes,
Seed
you
of
are.
Chucky. Seed of Chucky.
2004. That's the year we graduated high school.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Yeah. Funny fact.
I'm here.
Really?
Fun fact.
Yeah. 04?
You did?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're all the same age. 31, right? You just turned 31,
yeah.
Rob.
Yeah, I just turned 31, February 27th. I didn't get a Christmas card.
Happy birthday to Rob.
Christmas card.
From anybody. Jennifer Tilly didn't call me.
No, that's never going
to
happen.
Wait, so we didn't really say happy birthday to you last week because it was your birthday was in this last week.
Because Rob didn't tell us, that's why. Yeah. Rob
didn't
tell anybody.
You're supposed to know,
how are we supposed to know it's your birthday?
Because Facebook tells you it's my birthday.
Yeah,
that's how I know who anybody's birthday is.
Facebook told us on the day of, which was the day after we recorded last week's podcast. So you could have said, hey, tomorrow's my birthday, and then we all could have been like,
That's just like weak sauce.
Well, now we can say it now. Happy late birthday, Rob.
Too late. I don't care.
We
don't give a shit anymore.
We love you. I love you, at least.
I'm 31. Stuff's falling apart. My knees hurt more now.
31 and done.
Downhill.
31 and done.
So I let's see the
Seed of Chucky.
Woohoo! It got
so
me,
funny.
It got me going.
It got a little out of hand.
It really got out of hand.
It got out of hand.
And it gave me false hope because I thought the opening scene was so badass. And
yes.
It just sort of went downhill from there. The shot, the POV from the doll and the shot of the doll stabbing the dad and then him falling off the banister.
Yeah,
that was the coolest shit ever.
And like the doll falling with him and then going back up the stairs and then finding the mom
in the
shower.
I thought that was so cool. It was so cool. And it just sort of went all downhill from there.
So that was like him dreaming and it was him behind the doll face.
He's having nightmares.
And we saw a little booby in the shower. From
yeah, we did. It wasn't Tilly's.
No. They were nice, though. They were perky and nice and at attention.
Cracked her skull on the floor.
I mean, does that really happen? How many slip and fall deaths occur with, like, your head cracking like a cantaloupe on the floor?
It was a little far-fetched. I mean...
Yeah, usually you'd put your hands down and you'd brace yourself, but, yeah.
To each their own.
Yeah.
And of those deaths, how many of them have their boobs perfectly covered up by the shower curtain? I guess we saw the boober on the close up at the end.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Saw a little bit.
All right.
There was like a little nipple sticking out. That was worth it.
That
was okay.
I thought the dad was eating raw meat when we first saw that opening scene, but it was a big thing of birthday cake.
Which they left out on the table, by the way.
with the knife in it.
I'd be so pissed. Who leaves the cake out? It's going to be stiff by morning.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Some people like stiff cake, man.
No one likes stiff cake.
Quit being so judgmental.
No one likes stiff cake.
Any cake is good cake.
Rob, next year on your birthday, I'll send you stiff cake. And you have to eat it.
Stiff cake.
Stiff cake's the best.
I'll send you stiff. Actually, hopefully you'll be living here by then, and then I'll just give you stiff cake.
Stiff angel food. Not angel food. Red velvet cake.
Oh, God, yeah. Oh. I didn't even have a cake for my birthday.
Really?
Like, it was the most lazy birthday you probably would have ever witnessed.
Did you have some good food at least?
What'd you do?
I woke up, watched like horror movies, whatever, lounged around. My vacation was that week, and I basically did absolutely nothing.
Hey, that's the best. Relaxation right, on your birthday? Right. Hell yeah.
I did nothing at all. No trips anywhere, no going to anybody's house. I just took it all in, man.
Sometimes a little relaxation is the best vacation. Because, you know, you don't have to do shit.
That sort of rhymed.
Little relaxation is the best vacation.
Yeah. Hashtag true story, man.
Yeah.
So, I think, how the fuck did Chucky get across the ocean? Not Chucky. His seed. Across the ocean, and now has an English accent and is doing...
I didn't catch any of that.
Yeah, like, it went by so fast.
Well, it happened in the opening credits when the little sperm cells were moving, you know?
Yeah, no, that was him being born. But, what... I mean...
Well, I guess they tried to play it off like...
The guy just said, I found him in a cemetery. Well, why was he in America in a cemetery in the first place?
Yeah. They should have had some backstory with that. Like,
yeah.
I got no idea. I got nothing. Like, I don't know. Maybe that's why they didn't put a backstory, because they were like,
we got no idea.
Yeah, he all of a sudden.
They didn't even have to do. Why did he have to be in England? Why couldn't he? Like, he could have been in Utah. He could have been anywhere. Yeah,
they must have just wanted Billy Boyd really bad to do the voice, and so he had to be English or something. I don't know.
I mean, but... I guess they still could have done a British accent, like a British guy found him. But why did he have to go back overseas with him?
And
like,
then how? How does he find the exact freight company that ships, I guess, props to this Hollywood studio?
Yeah.
Like, where's all that research?
He must have seen it on the TV when he was watching Chucky and Tiffany on television and saw the studio and looked it up. Googled it or something.
It just immediately got very far-fetched in the beginning.
This is 04, too. This is like pre-iPhone, guys.
Yeah.
This is like U.S. Cellular, those old Nokia brick phones.
Oh, yeah.
You know the ones that just could not die.
Mm-hmm. Like, oh, yeah.
This is pre-texting. How did he look this up?
Pre-flip phone,
yeah,
right?
I didn't have a flip phone.
I had a flip phone as a senior.
I had a flip phone, but a very shitty flip phone.
Because y'all are like the 1%, okay? Look, us down here, we didn't have flip phones till like 09.
You guys didn't have indoor plumbing till 09.
No, it's still a little sketchy. Like,
Florida's not like Mississippi. Come on now.
No, we're not quite there.
Yeah, but you're in Tallahassee. God. I just got back from Orlando, which was a good time, by the way.
That's right.
Florida. So I'm not going to rag on Florida too much. Because
you were all texting me. It's humid. It's all humid. My nuts are balmy.
It was too humid. My nuts were balmy.
Balmy.
I told you, you got to get that gold bond, medicated with like the mint in it.
That sounds like it would burn. Mint?
It does a little bit. It does. But it's cooling. It's nice.
Is that
I'll take a can to Disney with me next time.
Is that a powder form? Is that like a liquid form?
Oh, yeah,
like
powder form.
Oh, yeah. Keeps it
dry. Don't put it on when you get straight out of the shower. That's like putting on Icy Hot. You got to like let it dry, let it air out, then put a little bit on there and get a little tingle.
Mm-hmm.
When it tingly, burny, that's how you know it's working.
Ah. So.
How did... Glenn, well, I guess Glenn's the son of Chucky and Tiffany. Chucky and Tiffany are American. They
Glenn's
have American accents. Why would he have a British accent?
Well, because his owner who found him is
that's
British.
Right. So that's why I see. At the British ventriloquist contest.
Yeah,
thing.
So that whole just intro and opening was just...
And he's already in America. If you were going to be a famous ventriloquist, why would you go back overseas?
I don't know.
Like, you would just stay in America. I mean, I don't. It just doesn't work.
And
geography in these movies just don't work. Yeah. Geography in the last movie didn't work. Why you would go from wherever you were into Canada to go back into Jersey. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah.
And also, can we just all notice the complete ripoff of New Nightmare?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I mean, basically a movie within a movie.
Oh, yeah.
Chucky, Tilly playing herself, and I mean, come
Tilly
on.
Playing Tilly playing Tiffany.
Yeah, Tilly, who's playing Tilly playing Tiffany?
In, that really confused
me. Chucky Goes Psycho.
I was like, wait, she's supposed to be... And yeah, the movie within a movie.
I think they should have picked someone besides Tilly. I know you are obsessed with her.
No.
Well,
I'm sorry.
Mancini wanted to bring Tilly in as her physical form.
Notice
again.
It's Mancini now because Scotty was wrong on the pronunciation of Mancini when he tried to correct all of us.
I just thought.
I kind of like Mancini better, though.
I like Mancini.
Well, it's Mancini.
Well, his name is spelt with a ch sound, which is the C there, but who knows?
I think
it is Mancini.
I just think it was way too confusing to have Tilly play. Okay, because obviously now in Bride of Chucky, that woman is someone totally different who. In this universe now, because Tilly has brought herself as an actress into the Chucky world, the same world that Bride of Chucky happened. So by doing that, it's like saying that Tiffany used to be like the exact lookalike of Jennifer Tilly.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like an X-Files doppelganger, man. It happens all the time.
It doesn't work.
And it was weird.
I'm not sure about that. I think anything with Jennifer Tilly works.
Yeah, well, hey.
Especially your penis.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Exactly.
Oh,
it didn't work with her throwing herself at Red Man or whatever. She's too classy for that.
Yeah. Yeah, it was just weird. How would they film a movie with Tiffany and Chucky in it? They must have known the events that happened in Bride of Chucky. Like, it was all over the news, and they're like, oh, let's make a movie about it.
Well, yeah, that's what they said, that they found these two dolls at the crime scene and was never explained further,
yeah,
so it turned into
yeah.
this urban legend, and now they're making a movie
like
out of
6 years later, yeah.
It's Katherine Heigl's fault, okay?
Oh,
I'm just
shit.
Gonna set it out there. It's all her fault. Okay, Jennifer Tilly is an American just legend. I mean, she's a prize.
Mm-hmm.
And her portrayal of this particular character, as in herself playing herself,
yeah.
who once played a girl that looked like her that died, that turned into a doll. It was.
See,
it
you
was,
lost everybody.
Yeah,
you
no,
lost
no, it
everybody
was seamless.
There.
It was just absolutely seamless.
You already lost
no
everybody.
Holes.
No
plot.
Holes. No holes.
Although I was actually jumping for joy and so excited because John Waters was in it.
He was funny.
Yeah, he
yes,
was pretty good.
John really Waters.
Funny. And apparently,
the reporter, the camera guy.
I watched an interview with Mancini, and apparently he heard through the grapevine that John Waters was a fan of Chucky, and specifically mm-hmm. like Bride of Chucky. And had said he always wanted to be murdered in a slasher film mm-hmm. by the killer. And so Don literally wrote this part for him, hoping he would do it, and then reached out to him. And sure enough, he did
like,
it.
Yep, I'll do it.
So
I thought it was hilarious.
He was
this
great.
One is this one like kind of steps over the edge once or twice, but for the most part, it is. It's absolute insanity, and I did kind of like it. I thought it was pretty good.
There's
there
just
are some
too much going. There's too much going on. And
yeah.
Too much to follow.
You're just hung up on Tilly, and I understand that. You're just not. You're not used to.
They
just being so awestruck by an actress.
They could have used Sigourney Weaver. That would have been fine. Whatever you want,
no,
Rob.
No,
Tilly was good.
No. Tilly was fantastic.
She just fits
as
that
always.
Tiffany voice, that part, just
kind of
trashy voice.
That was a
not
lucky
voice,
turkey
just,
baster.
She plays the trashy girl.
You know what? Where I think the best boobs were the doll boobs.
Oh yeah,
she did have
Tiffany's
some good
doll
ones.
Boobs.
Those were some good
they were
doll
good.
Boobs.
That was funny as hell.
I've never seen those on a Barbie.
No. I thought they gave a good opportunity. Like Tilly even made fun of herself. Like she's like, no, you're thinking of Bound or something. Like she was even making fun of her old movies. But
she admitted that she was. Oh, someone must have died or
Amber
stolen
Alert.
A kid.
Amber Alert.
They're missing. They're missing.
Amber
Who
Alert. 2008
kill?
White
Who did Steve,
Acadia breast cancer.
What poor child did Steve
Steve's
grab?
Steve's not in the backyard.
The
he's not in the backyard.
Well, no, he's in the front yard snatching your neighbor's children.
So Tilly even admitted she was fat in the movie. Like I said, she's a little chunky. She even admitted
I
it.
I like that. I like that.
Yeah, you gotta have, yeah, you know.
A little more cushion.
A little girth, a little cushion. Something to grab onto.
It's all about, that's spooning right there. That's yeah. just freezing to death. You need something to grab a hold of.
So, obviously, the doll boobs were a little over the top, and so was Chucky masturbating.
Oh, dude. So he has to have some jerking off material, so he had all those mags and then the doll boobs. And, I freaking
I just
love
the silhouette
yeah,
of him
yeah.
masturbating. And I guess it took five puppeteers to get Chucky masturbating.
Dude, if I was one of those puppeteers, I'd be just laughing my
ass
off.
I watched some behind-the-scenes footage, and sure enough, one guy's in the corner with you know, whatever they have to use, some kind of digital sensor, something just... like jacking off.
Yeah. I love John Waters' line, masturbating midget? Oh, God bless the little people.
I was pretty impressed with the finishing product because, I mean, they filled a whole turkey baster. I mean,
yeah, well,
oh, yeah. What do I do with this?
Are you saying that, actually, that was sort of a lot. I'll admit that.
That was a lot.
I'll admit that.
That was like a half gallon.
That was like a laundry detergent liquid cap.
I think I could fill up close. I got a pretty big payload going on. I'll just have you know that one of my ex-girlfriends in high school used to call me Chief Bust Big Nut.
Chief Bust Big Nut. Hey. Well, they say if you don't get a lot of sex and you wait a long time to like jerk off and masturbate, like if you know,
I don't know about that.
Then you just have more that's building up and building up, and then when it comes out, there's
just
more and more.
I'm just saying, I could fill like four belly buttons.
Wow. Smaller belly buttons.
All
right. Just line them up.
Line them up. Oh.
He had a lot in him because he wasn't getting laid as much as I was, so he had a lot right. in him that was building up. Because I had little amounts when it came out.
Scotty just took care of business so often. That
oh yeah,
Scotty
was,
just
it was just
always
it was just
care
air
business.
That came out.
I was like Jennifer Tilly in this movie.
Scotty just wasn't picky whatsoever.
Oh, I was picky.
Oh.
Yeah. I wasn't as bad as some.
I'm
going to
start posting some of the tragedies Scotty may have been with over the years.
There wasn't many. There wasn't many.
There's at least a few, though.
I think it
doesn't matter. He's got Mrs. Scotty boning with her.
We've all
powdered
had our...
sugar applicators.
Oh, yeah.
What other
that's right.
kind of crazy, freaky stuff y'all are
so
into?
Was anyone else bothered that when the Glenn / Glinda found the parents, all she had to do was just read the fucking words on the back of the amulet.
The
I mean, and anyone could have. Like, it seems like this ritual is just getting easier and easier. Like in the first one,
yeah, the first two or three movies, there's some memorization involved.
Yeah, there's clouds coming in.
It was secretive, and this one is kind of like they just read. It seems like in the first three, it took longer. Like, I mean, it was a big epic thing and building up and. In this, it's like, yeah, you know, whatever, you know, hocus pocus, kazam, and then boom.
Just,
the
just,
bodies
you know,
are switched.
Yeah, there was like a...
Ade Dewey Dembala them, they'll wake right up. That's it. It's like, I guess since it's happened so much, you do it enough times, it just...
Yeah.
Maybe doesn't take much anymore.
The gods are there. They, you know, each time you do it, there's
but
a
he's like, up. He's like, here. And I don't know how he knew to read them. He just turned it over. He's like, ah. And then it's like, yeah, a light bulb came on.
Whatever.
He just reads three lines, and then they just basically just wake right up. I was like,
He resurrected them.
That's it.
Yeah, it seemed like there was more to it for the earlier films. Like, he had this big, grand voice, and now it's just the little British voice of Glenn, whatever, doing it.
And also...
I mean, at least this movie holds up. I mean...
Yeah.
You know, even back in 2004, we were having gender
identification or
yeah, issues,
gender,
if you will.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. I mean, because gender is just a social construct, you know, and it took a genius like Mancini to bring this to light.
That's
and now,
Mancini.
You know, Mancini. Yeah.
Mancini,
and then,
Mancini, same thing.
Yeah, I like Mancini, man. Mancini sounds like he's,
Mancini.
You know, he's
Mancini.
Like a union labor boss for the Italian mob.
Yeah,
it makes more sense to me.
Union Italian mob is our union positions now.
Well, that's their cover. Have you guys watched Goodfellas?
Yeah.
You don't see
actually that was part of my birthday like thing. I sat down and just wall to wall Goodfellas, Casino, Godfather, everything. Was
Wait,
great.
Just the first Godfather?
I didn't do three. I do one and two, and I don't like Pacino. I just don't like Pacino. Just,
well, then
know,
how'd you get through one and two?
See, you don't.
He's not as flamboyant. You know, like in three, he's. You know, in three, he's in the kitchen faking a heart attack and hoo-ah! Oh my God!
That's true.
They just bring me back in and just. Yeah.
And two is mostly De Niro, I guess.
Well, that was where it all came, you know, where they butted heads, De Niro and him. But
yeah.
De Niro's better. Close and shut.
Pacino's pretty good in Scarface, though, I must say that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But his C doesn't have H in it. It's Pacino. You don't say Pacino.
Yes, because that's why it's Mancini.
See, that's what I thought. Mancini, Mancini. Yeah.
These are facts, Danny.
Anyways,
what were you even saying, Rob, before we...
I was saying that it's pronounced Mancini. Scotty backed me up. It's 2-1.
It was something different than that. Oh,
we were talking about Casino.
Labor bosses and unions.
Well, anyways...
I was talking about that, you know, Mancini, you know, he broke the barrier down so that we can have open dialogue about gender.
Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah, yeah, that's what you were saying. Moving on.
It was kind of cool. There was a lot of like family drama between them in this, with adding Glenda in it.
Well,
a lot of family like bickering and drama and like,
and it almost
Chucky
turned
being the dad, and
it turned it into. It wasn't really a horror movie for me. It was like a comedy slash.
Yeah.
I don't know, and Mancini admits that with Bride of Chucky, it was obviously a lot different than the first three, but it still had a dark overtone or undertone, and it walked the fine line almost perfectly between comedy and horror, sort of like Evil Dead 2. And
this one kind of crossed the line more into the comedy.
And he said that one was more about a... obviously, it walked the line good, comedy horror, and it was more about their relationship. He had, if you noticed in Bride of Chucky, Chucky was courting, they had a date, it was all, it went through a normal human-like relationship. And he said that in this one, he wanted to be just as different from Bride of Chucky as Bride of Chucky was from the first three.
A whole different thing.
And he wanted to go over the top and create this more of a family drama, soap opera type feel between the two characters. And so, I mean, he achieved what he went out to
off.
Do
yeah.
because it is way over the top. But even he in the interview is like, I sort of messed up.
I think
like, sorry for this
I
one.
I think this one had the most fan like
backlash.
Yeah. For
I can see that because I
better
think
term.
I think a lot of people that were going to see this, and if you went to the movie theater, it's kind of like your fault. I don't really feel bad for you.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, Seed of Chucky. But I think a lot of people were drawing the similarity that Danny just made with you got Evil Dead, which was a very gritty, dark kind of out there movie. And then Evil Dead 2 comes along and it's kind of like the perfect mix.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a perfect mix. And I think a lot of people were expecting this to be Army of Darkness, to where...
Yeah.
It is. It's more campy, but it's more campy like action hero campy, you know, but it still has some serious horror. And this one just had, I mean, this had John Waters in it. I mean, this was by no means, I don't even consider it a horror movie. It's entertainment, but
yeah,
there is no real conflict.
It's like a slasher
it's
comedy.
It's just
slasher comedy.
Just, I mean, and even some of the deaths were. They were just pure comedic. I mean, like when she gets Red Man and they're like, it's like steaming sausage just pouring out.
Oh,
I mean,
God,
it's not even gruesome.
It
I mean, it's just like
sausage.
It's weird.
Or the death of the special effects guy with his head popping off.
That was cool.
That was cool.
Yeah. Like a zip wire that freaking
so
went
that,
on his neck.
And that was Tony Gardner, who actually was the special effects or makeup guy for Seed of Chucky and then Curse of Chucky. Played himself in it So that was pretty cool that to have him do that.
I think this was it probably wasn't even like a labor of love. I just think this was like, well, they gave me like a massive budget for Bride and we made a lot of money and people really, really liked it. And they're going to give us a ton of money. Mm-hmm. And I wouldn't doubt, maybe they've never come out and say it, but I wouldn't doubt if there is somebody like truthfully, like we don't know if they're ever going to give us money to do another one. So let's just go all out.
Yeah.
Like any ideas. Oh, John Waters. I heard John Waters. Oh, cool. Let's get him. Oh, hey, you know, you did Bride of Chucky. You're the effects guy. Hey, let's have somebody cut your head off. Okay. That's hilarious. And I think that's why Jennifer Tilly played herself in it.
So many people playing themselves.
I think they all just loved it. I think they all just loved it. And they were like, let's just go crazy. Let's just, you know, oh, you got a cousin? Cool. Bring him in.
Yeah.
Let's have fun.
And Redman playing Redman, you know, and
well, and Mancini did talk about how he had wrote the script for this directly after they were done with Bride of Chucky, and wanted to film it sooner, but Columbine happened, the Columbine shootings, and the studio didn't really want to put out this kind of material, and so I can't remember if he said that they sold it or they just held off on it for a while. It actually ended up getting released by, well, Rogue Pictures, which is their first movie. It's actually a offshoot of Focus Features. They didn't want to release it under the Focus Features name because Focus Features at the time is sort of known for these indie, super artsy films.
Yeah.
And so they're like, well, we don't want to release this Seed of Chucky under Focus Features, so let's just create Rogue Pictures and
it's
do
still
it.
Affiliated with Universal,
yeah,
but
Universal.
Not, didn't have the name Universal
and so, on
it.
But anyways, Don had written this script, had to shelve it for a while, and then ended up, 2004, six years later. So if I hadn't heard that, I'd be surprised they waited so long to do this.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
So it would have been released sooner if that didn't happen.
Yeah.
Along with the House of Thousand Corpse, too, that they're talking about. And
yeah, Universal sold that one at the time because... They didn't want to release it during the Columbine shootings.
It was during the same time, but,
yeah. Yeah, they should have never released that. But it's just.
I didn't think it was that bad.
And well, then I understand
studios being like that, and I do, but House of a Thousand Corpses maybe a little bit different.
Yeah,
these are a couple of dolls.
Yeah,
like. You know, I think stuff like that is funny and humorful, and it doesn't hurt anybody, you know.
Don't take it serious, yeah.
Yeah, just, I don't think anybody takes this seriously, you know. And it's kind of like a lot of movies got a lot of really bad backlash. And when you go back and actually watch the movies as old 31-year-olds, you're like, why was this ever considered dangerous? Like, this is the stupidest crap I've ever seen in my life.
That's why you can do comedy, because they're dolls, you know. It's like, hey, they make it funny. I mean, they're dolls killing people, you know. And
I wonder how much of his script that he did change because of that. I wonder how much of it, you know, he shelved it, but I wonder how much of the script, how much funnier the script got the longer it sat there. Like,
yeah,
how much further away he decided to write away from any serious horror and just put out just to get Rogue, just to get anybody to release it, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know, man. I mean, for Christ's sake, it has a Britney Spears lookalike, by the way.
I was really hoping it was her, but
I know,
I checked
too.
The credits. It wasn't.
Apparently,
you're his asshole.
And apparently, in the preview, they had to state Britney Spears is not in this film. Because her agent made him do that or something, so that they wouldn't bank on people wouldn't show up expecting to see Britney Spears. It was a Britney Spears lookalike.
It was so funny. Is this the first time we see Chucky driving a car?
Yeah, he wouldn't do it before.
Yeah,
so I don't know. That was another slight hole I thought too.
Or did he have? No, he had those little things to his feet. Yeah.
Well, no,
right.
he had Glinda. Glinda was operating the pedal.
Yeah.
Glinda was.
But I recall in one of the previous movies. He said he couldn't drive because obviously he's too small.
I thought he had like little wood things like attached to his feet in one of the movies, and he was driving one time.
Not that I can think of.
But yeah, and then of course we see John Waters get his slasher death finally with the acid pouring on his head.
I took photos. I mean, I took like photography in high school. I don't remember like keeping massive amounts of like sulfuric acid just chilling out in the dark room. I'm fairly certain that we didn't. I mean, I may be wrong, but
he looks sort of like a creeper, so who knows what he had going on in there.
And of course, he didn't get killed by Chucky. He got killed by Glenn.
Glenda.
Yeah.
Glenn.
So he really didn't
I'm
get
not
his
sure
wish.
If it was a boy or a girl.
No.
He really didn't get his wish of being killed by like an infamous, you know, slasher character like Chucky. He got killed by his son, daughter, person.
Well, it had to be good enough.
It.
While we're
moving... I was actually really disturbed by the doll wedding itself. For some reason, that was really like,
And if he had no genitalia, where was the bee coming out of? That's what I wanted to know.
Butt pee.
There's that is
no
true.
Hole. There's no hole.
It was butt pee.
I used to think when I was little that, because, you know, when you're little, you just go in the bathroom with your mom and she'd pee. I just, for the longest time, I thought she peed out of her butt. I just assumed that. I was like, oh, girls pee out of their butts.
Yeah, well, that's what I assumed.
I just wanted to share that. I don't know why.
Well, they don't. I mean, you got to tell people.
Well, yeah.
Because there could be like an 11-year-old with his iPhone listening to us. They don't actually. At least, I'm not
should
sure.
Not be an 11-year-old
I'm fairly,
listening
I'm fairly
to us.
Certain that they don't.
I bet you there's a couple
of
11-year-olds listening to us.
I bet they will if you give them some like raunchy Mexican food.
He's like, Mommy, where's your pee hole?
Pee out of their butt.
Where'd you hear that? It was on a cult classic horror show.
Uncle D.
I'm sorry.
Uncle Danny and Scotty told me to ask you.
Damn it, I told you not to listen to that show. That Rob is a pervert.
They always talk about
he's got an unhealthy
boobs.
Obsession with Jennifer Tilly.
They talk about butt
and
pee.
Sigourney Weaver and Tom Atkins.
Oh, there's nothing unhealthy about Tom Atkins. I am over Sigourney, though. Man, she's
oh,
been
God.
Replaced.
Oh, you're over her now.
I'm over, man. All that. I'm focusing on Tilly. I'm just.
Okay.
Just...
So we got a new girl on the block right. here. Why the hell was Red Man invited back to dinner?
That's what I was just going to say. I was just going to say that. Why is
he
the
comes
next,
once?
Why is the next scene them at a lavish dinner table like he lives there now? He was there for a one night stand.
And they woke
because
up.
Because she is his baby mama,
that's
potentially.
The stupidest thing I've ever seen. It just switches to, like, a feasting scene straight out of, like, a like 1859.
Like a six-course dinner that she prepared for him. And God.
Yeah, she's a woman right there.
That was funny. Before that, the injection of Chucky's sperm, how, like, the digital sperm
that
dropping
digital
down.
Digital sperm drop. That was definitely...
I wonder if somebody saved that turkey baster. I wonder if it's on eBay.
Oh,
I'll
yeah.
pay any amount of money.
I doubt it actually
it
touched Tilly's vagina.
Touched
you
Tilly's
don't know.
Vagina.
She could be like, what do you call it? Like a method actor or whatever. She has to be in the moment.
A method man actor. Method actor. Method man.
See, and where, is, man, and where Red does man. Red Man come out of nowhere? Because I've seen Method Man in a ton of movies. But what fucking Red Man? What has
What's
he done?
Wrong with Red Man?
Has he done anything else?
He's done some, a few things, I think.
I think he did a movie with Method Man. That mm-hmm. one where they cheated to get into Harvard.
High?
Or
was it
whatever.
Called
oh,
high?
How High?
How High?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
I don't know why I know that.
And why are they? Is that like Method Man was in Wu-Tang, right?
Yeah.
So was Red Man.
Are you, Red
I
Man
it was
just
Met,
it was Red
Meth
Man too?
That was in Wu-Tang.
Well, where is Red Man from?
Red why Man's do, just by himself.
Why
He's
do they
a solo
why
artist.
Do they look alike? Are they brothers?
It may be. Because
so
it was what
I
it
mean,
was. It
both?
Was the RZA, the GZA,
old
Method
dirty
Man,
bastard,
old dirty bastard,
ODB.
No, so
maybe that was it.
I mean,
so here's.
I mean, both their last names are Man.
Method Man
That's
was
true. They could be related.
Method Man was in Wu-Tang, and then after Wu-Tang, he teamed up with Red Man, and then they did the Method Man Red Man record together. So, but they were our Mancini wrote this role for Quentin Tarantino.
Oh yeah, Red, yeah, we didn't mention that
Red Man's part, but Quentin Tarantino did not do it.
No,
I prefer Red Man.
Mancini,
I prefer Red Man to Quentin Tarantino.
Mancini wrote Tarantino a letter. And Tarantino just threw a liaison and said, nope, not doing it.
He, like, wrote him a letter and said, like, Jennifer Tilly will have, like,
make-out
sessions
and
make-out scenes.
And whoever did
and
the
stuff.
Music, Tarantino was a fan of the composer, and Mancini thought that might clinch it for him, but obviously it didn't.
Yeah.
So.
No, instead, Quentin Tarantino wrote, like, a 18-page letter with the middle that started the first, and then the ending was in the middle, and then the beginning was at the end, and we were all like, oh, you're a genius, and you...
How could you think that Redman would be better than Tarantino?
Anybody is better than Tarantino.
I think Tarantino, as an actor, has done all right.
Tarantino is a hack, sir. Robert Rodriguez is the genius behind him.
Robert Rodriguez is... I'm reading his book right now about how he came up. It's pretty fucking interesting, actually. You guys should...
Robert Rodriguez is a genius. He has that... He has his own channel now.
He basically walked into Hollywood at like 23 years old, and they all bowed down to him. That's basically what happened.
Because what? Did he do stuff before
That's
that?
That's literally what happened. He came to Hollywood to... So he made El Mariachi for like $7,000 in Mexico. And he came to Hollywood to meet with... Mexican video producers. Mm-hmm. So the straight to video Mexican video market, which was like bottom of the rung for directors. Mm-hmm. And he's like, if I can make this film, I can sell it to the Mexican video market. They'll give me more money to make another film, and I can practice. I can make like 3 Mexican video films before I take a shot at Hollywood. And so he went to Hollywood because that's where the Mexican video market film people were, tried to sell it to him while he was there. He just dropped off his demo reel, like at one of the big agencies, just because. And they were all like, oh my God. And they all wanted.
I thought I heard somewhere like he edited and did everything for El Mariachi, like on cassette.
Oh, on VHS. Yeah. Dude, he had like a video camera and like a, you know, double deck VCR. And he was literally.
Yeah, he would,
that's
yeah, he
how
would
he
stop
edited
and
it.
Record. And
insane.
He would have one. He would have his. He'd have to plan it out meticulously. And he'd have. One tape in the deck would be the raw footage of him shooting. And he'd only have one shot at this. The tape in the other deck, you know, there's a button between, you can hit record from one tape to the other. And he would literally sit there and time it out and wait. And he knew where like the good parts and the scenes he wanted, and he'd hit record, and then he'd record onto the tape. Then he'd hit stop. And then the raw footage would keep going. And then when the next part came he wanted, he'd hit record onto the tape and stop.
That seems so tedious.
And that's how he made El Mariachi.
God.
Yeah. And El Mariachi is actually a good movie.
I actually need to watch it.
Me too.
And from El Mariachi basically came Desperado, if you guys
Yeah, and
know.
Then Once Upon a Time in Mexico. Yeah,
which is all Robert Rodriguez.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then it's like the Grindhouse movies. They were all Robert Rodriguez, even though Quentin Tarantino was attached. When they did Inglourious Bastards, the first half of the movie is Robert Rodriguez.
Yeah.
And then the second half, which you can barely watch because it's just a whole bunch of German subtitles and Quentin Tarantino's brilliant dialogue, that's Tarantino.
Mm-hmm. Dust Till Dawn from Dust Till Dawn.
Yeah.
Which
a whole bunch of Pulp Fiction and a whole bunch of Reservoir Dogs, there was a lot of collaboration, but like, but like what you said, like Robert Rodriguez was so young and kind of new to it. He, into the all the interviews I've seen with him, he's very modest. He's not like he's very good at what he does. Mm-hmm. I mean, he owns a TV network now. Like, I mean, this dude's incredible.
Yeah. And I think Tarantino did, as an actor, did decent in Pulp Fiction and in Dust Till Dawn.
Dust Till Dawn, yeah.
So
yeah, he's funny. I like Tarantino. I just there's a waft about Tarantino that just
he's in Reservoir Dogs too. Yeah, he's good.
Anyways,
he's funny though. He is funny.
Anyways, yeah, Redman was a horrible actor.
They had Pantoliano up for the role too before Redman, but that didn't pan out.
Yeah, basically Redman was last choice.
But he was thrilled to be. He's like, yeah, I'll be in it. Yep. He's a big-time Chucky fan, too.
So. Oh,
holy
Chucky! Oh, man.
I just chucked my pants full of poop.
I just bust big nutted all over the place.
Got chucks of chuck. Okay,
that means
it's time. The
horror halftime. All right.
Goodness gracious.
I am a little disappointed. Not very much competitors.
Yeah, this is
week.
Just... What's going on here?
We get a lot of listeners for Chucky, but no participators. So I don't know what's wrong
People
with
are lazy.
Guys.
People are lazy.
So,
it just happens.
I mean,
just joking, guys.
David Mace, I got a shout
out.
I'm not joking.
I'm not. Get off your butt. All you got to do is make a meme. It's easy. It's not hard.
Just Google how to make a meme if you don't know how to do it.
It's pretty easy these days. But I got a shout out to David Mace because he had a pretty funny Tom Atkins cyborg collection of memes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And But and then Ty, of course, had some awesome Tilly memes. The boobers, not cardboard tits, yep. was my favorite.
And the Titanic one, the guitar in the... is that the guitar in the bathtub?
It's like a model of the Titanic.
It looks like a model of the Titanic. A model of Titanic. Yeah. That's so funny.
And the Bill
With
Paxton.
The Bill Paxton. R.I.P.
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 And so anyways, I know we gave it to David a couple weeks ago, and Ty blogs for us. But you know what? I have not really sent Ty much of anything. So, Ty, you can win. You can win this
Ty,
week.
You are the horror halftime winner this week.
Ty is the horror freak of the week.
Horror freak of the week.
You can finally get some stickers that you've been bitching about. I'll send you some damn stickers.
He is part of the cult classic
Actually,
horror.
Actually, that's probably what I'll send you both.
Staff,
I'll send you
say.
Like an envelope full of stickers, and then maybe I'll send you a shirt too, but that's sort of a pain because the shirts come from the warehouse and the stickers come from me, so... I gotta pay
don't push your luck, Ty.
I gotta pay
seriously.
Double postage to your ass, man. So you just let me know, Ty. Do you want like 10 stickers or do you want a t-shirt? You just let me know.
The best part about the stickers is that you get Danny's actual address. Because at least
it's
when
true.
He sent it to me, I got Danny's address. And I just saved the envelope. I got it in my nightstand. It's like my just in case.
Handwritten, right? It was handwritten by me.
Oh yeah, it was handwritten. It was it was lovely.
All you other guys got stickers too. Handwritten
by
addressed envelope with Cult Classic Horror stickers in it from me.
By yours truly,
I
Danny
will
Bunning.
Let you know I have since ordered. I now have Cult Classic Horror official return labels. So I won't write that part
so
out.
So they won't be handwritten.
But I will still be handwriting your name and address on the envelope. So
and then, Ty, you can keep his address and then send him naughty things.
Ty already
later.
Has my address because he sent me that awesome Dawn of the Dead.
Oh, that's right.
Signed by Tom Savini poster that's hanging on my wall
it's
right now.
It's framed and hung up in the,
it is.
The official recording studio.
It is hung.
Danny's
right
got
there.
Nothing to worry about with Steve in that house from what I've heard.
No.
Like, two man enter, no man leave.
So, Ty, horror freak of the week. So yeah, let's just keep this going. Like, just fucking send us some Chucky memes, you guys. Let's do this.
Yes. Preferably one of Chucky jerking off with the
shadow
or something.
Let's
get
a Chucky jerking off
or him
meme.
With like the sperm cup or something.
That's, I mean,
anything like that.
Doll masturbating, large load. There's tons of memes to be had.
Oh, so many good ones.
We'll make it our profile pic.
Yeah. We might if it's good enough. Probably not. But send it anyways.
You could do one of Red Man's sausages falling out of his body. Yeah.
That was just
links.
The weirdest thing, man. Why was it steaming?
And man,
and he was like sitting up, like talking still.
And if you can, make sure to post it on Twitter and tag us at CC Horror. All right, that concludes the horror halftime.
Back into it. Speaking of the Red Man at dinner, he's getting killed. And he's like, and then Tilly comes out. Do you mind? I'm on the phone.
Well, he barely utters. He's like, he yells out her name, right? He's like, Jennifer. Like she probably wouldn't even be able to hear him if she wasn't on the phone. He's like, Jennifer. And she's like, do you mind? I'm on the phone.
It's probably
she
all the sound.
I bet
steam.
She has the voice of an angel. She's
Rob,
not
she
awful.
Sounds really naggy to me. I don't
do
think you want to be with her.
I'm on the phone.
I like it.
Do you mind? I'm on the phone.
I don't think
she's
Savannah.
She's probably like really naggy, and she probably like, you know, just gives you a look of disapproval all the time. It's nice.
I don't think Savannah appreciates your obsession.
Probably not. She doesn't listen to the show though. So
oh,
okay.
Really? Oh, okay.
And she's not around.
Sure,
I say that now,
but I wouldn't doubt if she just does just to screen me.
Yeah.
She's and of course this is all you know on the interweb. So when it, you know, when she finally snaps. Or kills me or whatever. She's got enough evidence piled up.
She's secretly listening to all these episodes, and she's got some. She like records everything you say in it.
My wife doesn't listen to the show. She used to. No, she doesn't anymore.
Yeah, my wife.
Son, everything's free game. My cousin does though. Kathleen told on me. Kathleen, you told on me.
What? I wonder if Kathleen's going to tell on your big nuttin'
what did
McGillicuddy?
What did you tell
whatever.
Me about Kathleen? Shannon like came to me yesterday or 2 days ago. She's like, you said this on this. I can't. Oh, she said, I think you just told her we talked about masturbating for like 15 minutes straight.
And it wasn't 15.
And my wife came to me and she's like, are Kathleen, she says that you should be embarrassed of yourself.
Oh my God. Hey, that's all right.
I'm like, whatever. Kathleen's probably locked in on us a couple times.
That's when you tell your wife, what have I told you? You never look me in the eye.
Anyways.
Never look me in the eye and you should know I have no shame. That was pretty good. That was pretty heated just because Danny for some reason doesn't believe that it sticks with high heat.
Mine doesn't, so I don't know what you guys are all made out of.
Oh, yeah, it does. I don't know what happened. In the shower, for sure. Nope. Look, we probably shouldn't talk about that again for 20 minutes.
Another thing, so at the end, near that, since we're sort of going through the film here, and I do have a bunch of other behind-the-scenes shit, but I was going through my comments. The cops come in. They see the burnt-up fucking assistant on the ground, and they just waltz right on up to the room. There's no guns drawn, no backup called. It's like the two dumbest cops in the world.
Yeah, yeah. They come up with just flashlights, and then, of course, they see Jennifer Tilly there with all the bodies. Yeah, that was a little like they were rent-a-cops or something. What the hell was going on there?
And then what's this Carrot Top daughter? She looks like freaking Merida straight out of Brave. Sorry.
Are you talking about like the very end?
Yeah. Yeah, oh, the very end. That was just, she just looked like a costume doll child, even though she was real. The boy
there was a wig. She was wearing a wig.
The boy
sure.
looked believable, but the girl was like, what the fuck is that?
I just love at the very end, too, when, you know, Chucky breaks down the door with the axe, too, and he sticks his head. And, you know, obviously, I thought he was going to say, here's Chucky. But he's like, I can't think of anything to say.
Yeah, it was a real...
yeah.
That was great.
Notice how they referenced the legendary
Jack Nicholson.
Great movie.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, agree to disagree.
I love that this must have happened when Martha Stewart got caught, too, because I love
going
that line. They're executing Martha Stewart? Just going to jail.
Pretty good. And I guess, and then it turns out that he was Glinda, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Turned out he had it. Yeah.
So was anyone else surprised that Billy Boyd did this movie after doing like all the Lord of the Rings movies and shit?
I kind of was surprised about that.
That's right. This was after Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, Billy Boyd was the voice of Glenn / Glinda.
Mm-hmm.
And he just got done playing Pippin in like three of the biggest movies ever at the time.
And maybe Chucky was like his favorite.
I don't know. He didn't say that
or something.
I just thought that was a little crazy. That's all. He seemed a little bit. I guess he wasn't like the main part, but still, he was there.
But yeah, you think?
I wonder, what was the budget for this movie?
It was like $12 million. Estimated $12 million budget.
And the box office did double that, so it was $24.8 million.
See, I have $17 million as the box office. I don't know.
You probably looked on IMDb. I looked on Wiki.
Okay. Well,
it doesn't matter. I think that they're both relatively.
It didn't do too great, obviously.
Yeah.
So Billy Boyd, played Pippin, Lord of the Rings, did this right after. And also, Jason Fleming played Santa in the beginning. He's recognizable. He's been in a lot of stuff. Mm-hmm. He said this is the only film he'd erase from his resume.
Oh, God. That's a little rude.
I know.
Well, he was sitting there because they filmed this in Romania.
Yeah, he was quoted, or did you write the quote down? He was quoted as saying something like,
trying to memorize what he said.
I'm playing Santa Claus in Romania being murdered by a doll.
by two little dolls.
Where have I gone wrong?
Yeah, exactly. So this was filmed.
I'm sure he made some money.
Yeah.
I had to fly everyone out there.
That was a cool scene, too.
You're about to say it was filmed in Romania.
But he could say, I got killed by Chucky, you know?
Yeah.
Not many people could say that.
It was filmed on a soundstage, like the whole movie, in Romania. So it's all, none of it's really on location.
Castel soundstages in Romania.
Where Cold Mountain was
filmed.
I was just
going to say that.
Yeah, Cold
2003
Mountain.
Cold Chucky, Mountain.
Basically the same movie, right?
Yeah.
They filmed Cold Mountain in Romania?
Yeah, soundstage. That's what I read.
That's crazy.
I can't believe Cold Mountain was on a soundstage. That thing looks like it's on location, and it's such an epic movie.
Yeah, it seemed like there had to be some location in Cold Mountain.
Had to be.
But I don't know.
Like
maybe
tons
not.
Of snow and forest? I mean, I don't know. Anyways. Yeah.
So this
well,
is...
Well, I thought it was a good movie.
Yeah. And it is the only Chucky movie that contains nudity thus far. So that's something to say. Yeah. All the Friday 13, or all the
doll and human nudity.
Nudity. Yeah, it's all nudity.
And just for your information, when I had to look this up because I couldn't remember. When Tiffany calls the widow and apologizes, I guess that's from the cop she killed in the beginning of Bride of Chucky. Even now I'm trying to think of the cop. I was thinking of her boyfriend.
The very beginning?
When does she kill a cop in Bride of Chucky?
Oh, yeah.
Very beginning of the movie.
Or the one that Chris Sarandon's like partner. No, he doesn't get killed.
The beginning of Bride of Chucky.
Oh, Bride of Chucky, yeah.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, she slashes, she takes care of business.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're right. Okay.
Which when he's meeting her with the doll from like the evidence locker.
Oh, yeah, I remember now. Yep.
That's right. That's right. Okay. So, yeah, that was his widow.
Speaking of Chris Sarandon, he was actually offered the part in this, but he had scheduling conflicts. They keep trying to bring him back.
Yeah. Humperdink.
Humperdink.
So we said they did film this entirely on a soundstage in Romania. The way they had it set up was sort of cool. I saw some pictures and video. They had this whole, like the house was built inside, obviously, up on risers so that the puppeteers and crew could get underneath the floor. And then the tiles in the kitchen, they would remove certain tiles, and that's where all the cables and everything attached to the dolls would come up. So they're coming up like right behind them.
Mm-hmm.
And if the doll was moving to a different location on set, they would move to a different tile and pop everything up to the floor. And a lot of the puppeteers would be under the floor and some would be on top of the floor. And it's just a crazy mess.
Yeah. Gosh.
But
that'd be a cool experience to be out there. It's crazy how they have so many people, just one person working the eyes, one person working the hand, one person working the finger.
Eyebrows.
Eyebrows, and just, you got like 10 people on one doll.
Of course, they're here interviewing Redman on the set, and he's like, yo, man, this is shit out here in Romania, man. Of course, I was all up on it. Like, we in the gutter, we down in the hood, no Chucky, and we cool with Chucky. I'm like, oh, my
awesome.
God.
That's awesome. God,
I was like, get this fucking,
man, he's
got to
keep it real, dude. You got to keep it real in the streets.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all don't know, being up there in Colorado, you don't know what it's like, man.
You got to stay the character.
I mean, you don't know about the struggle, dog.
Yo, dog, are you down? Are you from the hood, Rob?
Oh, I mean, I was. I mean, I moved out, you know, I moved on up. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, shit.
813 Tampa Bay, represent. Y'all know.
Tampa.
don't be stunting on me. Now I live in Tallahassee in like the whitest neighborhood, but I mean, you know, I know where my roots.
Of course, from. Yeah, of course.
We're down here in Longmont, L Town, baby.
Mead.
Oh God,
technically Mead.
You're in Mead. I'm in
Longmont.
Yeah,
Danny's not in Longmont. Danny's in Mead.
Mead, where there's
you know how nice Mead is when there's no rentals.
Yeah, Hicktown, for sure.
Mead is actually, it's sort of hick out in the middle of...
It's country.
Prairie.
It's country town.
Although I'm in a suburb that belongs like in suburbia, or I don't even know how to say it. But anyways, but yeah, that's all I got on this movie. Entertaining, yes.
Yeah.
I just couldn't fly with the whole Tilly playing
yeah.
Tiffany...
It went over your head. It's okay. This movie makes you think.
I'm just saying, I think I like Tilly. I just think it would have been better if someone else played that part.
Yeah.
And Tilly was just
nobody
the
could
voice.
Play
Tilly,
Tilly but
just
Tilly,
did the
man.
Voice.
Tilly wasn't Tiffany's.
Well, it wouldn't be Tilly in the movie. It could be someone else playing themselves. It should have been like Jessica Alba playing Jessica Alba.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. No. I think there was a lot of fandom that wanted to see Tilly back in her, you know,
I think it was just
physical
Don
body.
Wanted to see Tilly back and wanted to try and bang her.
This was Don Mancini, I said it right. It was his directorial debut, I guess he was calling the shots.
He wanted her in there. They probably reenacted what actually happened in the like Red Man scene with Tilly.
Oh, yeah. motorboating the boobies to
That's
the face.
That's what actually happened, minus the doll murderings. So, yeah,
Red Man was getting all up in that.
Anyways, but yeah,
overall entertaining.
We got one more Chucky film left in the series here, Curse of Chucky. Even though I think they're coming out with another Chucky,
2017,
this year, or next year.
I think this year.
I think there's like a 2017 release.
Yeah, there is. I saw that on the interwebs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Damn old interwebs.
So I guess we'll miss that one. Maybe we'll come back around at some point.
Yeah.
But
we'll maybe I have to do a special. We'll have to all go see it in theater and come back and and give our opinions on it. Although I did see the newest one, which is on Netflix, which I guess is The Curse of Chucky.
That is on Netflix?
Yeah, it's on Netflix.
Sweet. I don't know.
The only problem with that one is it's missing what makes, at least to me, them so great. With there's not as, I guess there is some, but they're super, super, super heavy on the CGI.
Oh, geez.
And it's just
not the animatronics of before.
No, I miss that. You know, it's like, and this, that's what made the original Aliens so good, was like it took 36 people to operate the alien, and you can see it, you know, you can touch it. It's
well,
just different.
And they snuck some into this film. This is the first time I've noticed it.
Yeah.
First time with the Glenn running and actually Chucky walking a couple times. I just noticed it at a couple parts in this film where I was like, oh, they CGI'd that. So
I got a hand to Brad Dourif though. He's an awesome fucking Chucky voice. And I'm glad that he's stayed true and done all these movies and they haven't switched the character, you know?
Yeah.
So
yeah, no, I
love Brad Dourif.
Yeah.
And he seems to enjoy it. I mean, he keeps coming back. Mm-hmm. I know he was in this latest and greatest that I just saw that was on Netflix, The Curse. And I think I saw a YouTube promotional thing for the 2017, and he's involved with that one too.
Yeah.
So, and he was in Lord of the Rings too. So, hey.
He was in Lord of the Rings.
So, hey, he's here. He's here.
That's true. So,
him and Billy Boyd got reunited.
Yeah. But yeah, so Curse of Chucky next week. And then we'll be on to Rob's mind-blown favorite, Phantasm.
Yes.
Here we go.
Which,
so
if
many
you,
questions, so little answers.
If you guys haven't
we'll
noticed
you.
Yet, there's a new Phantasm design up in the horror store. It's pretty badass.
Oh, yeah.
So you guys should go buy it.
You got the
go
quadruple gauge shotgun and tall man.
Yeah.
Mixed together.
Quadruple barrel shotgun.
Barrel shotgun.
I'm ready for Scotty just to get like the half a... Good
Steve,
God, what is happening in Colorado?
All these Amber Alerts keep coming on.
Steve needs to calm his ass down.
Danny needs to silence his phone.
I thought it was silent. No.
Mine's silent. All right,
I'm done. Okay.
Silented.
Anyways.
I don't know what's going on. Y'all. I mean, I want to move up there, but I've heard so many alerts and stuff going on right now. I think I'm just going to stay down here in the swamp.
Your daughter's in danger up here, I guess.
Yeah.
So. Whoever messes with her is in danger. The girl is mean.
We'll Curse of Chucky next week. We'll be back.
Sounds good.
Thank you guys for joining us. We'll catch you next week.
Yeah, see you guys. It was fun.
See ya.
Don't you blame the movies. Movies don't create psychos. Movies make psychos more creative.
There will be blood.